See, I have never in my career seen a governing board behave the way it behaved today, particularly in the face of a governor-elect who had a congressman.
The Everglades Foundation says the Water Management District is breaking the law. They just voted on a land lease that could affect a reservoir project designed to improve our water quality. The vote announced late last night has the incoming governor and a congressman very angry. NBC2's Jacqueline Beavis was the only local reporter at the meeting.
Now, the Water Management District says they're just following Senate Bill 10. The bill requires the land keep making money until it's ready to be used for the Everglades Agricultural Area Reservoir. But the congressman and water advocates asked the district to hold off until the lease actually expires. The decision today was anything but a compromise.
All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
A vote supporting a new land lease between South Florida Water Management and New Hope Sugar.
The reason the board voted today was because they wanted to get started right away.
After a congressman and water advocates asked for just the opposite.
It's not the intent to prevent the use of this land. The intent is to say we don't want any additional hurdles.
Please fight for the public interest. We are the landlord.
All we were asking for was more than 12 hours notice to review what was going to be done with these new leases.
Voters and even the congressman saying that the short amount of public notice, less than 24 hours for the vote, makes it seem a bit fishy.
Gives it the impression that we're doing this in secret and that we're acting in secret.
The lessees were, I'm sure, given much more time than 12 hours to negotiate this new lease. The public wasn't given that same courtesy.
The request was not made that they never address these lease agreements until March. It's just don't change this as a voting item within hours before the vote.
The district says late negotiations caused that late notice.
We did not know whether or not we were actually going to have a contract to bring.
Adding that water is anything but political, even during election week.
This is following through on the direction to expedite a project.
But the congressman disagrees.
When you're putting a new leaser on the land, that's a big hurdle.
Now, two people did speak to the board in support of the vote today. Nearly 10 spoke out against it. The decision will possibly head toward a formal appeal at some point down the road. Live in the studio, Jacqueline Beavis, NBC2. A news